Because one, there's three optional objectives. One is to get corner kills, corner assassinations. I think you need three of them, so that should be pretty easy. The other one is assassinating a captain. That's the one thing that I just don't know what to do. And the other one is do not get hit by a fire line where you have a series of soldiers fighting. And I just aiming a rifle at you, and you can take a human shield. I just don't know how to actually do that, because if I don't, first of all, I don't know where the heck that captain is. Second of all, I don't know. I've never been able to get through that without getting hit by a fire line. The first part is pretty easy, but it's just, I'm just going to do a little bit of scouting ahead, just so that I don't spend like an hour. So I actually think I will be able to, apparently the general is marked, it's just I've never actually found him. Alright. I'm ready. As ready as I'm ever gonna be. Okay. This is probably gonna take a few tries, but it's just, I always struggle with this one. There's one that I just don't know how to do effectively. Just talk to everyone before you start the mission.
If I may, I was curious about your past with Braddock. You two clearly have a history.
Edward was one of us upon a time. I considered him a close friend. He was brave and bold in ways few men are. But everything changed at the siege of Bergen op Zoom. We had lost the fortress to the French, and were in the midst of egress. There was a skiff hidden at the port with which we planned to make our escape. As we drew near, a young man and his family came upon us, begging for safe passage. I consented, but Edward refused. The young man called him Craven then. So Edward killed him and all the rest. Even the children. To this day, I don't know why. Was this the first time he'd struck out? Or had I simply never seen it before? Either way, things were never the same after that. We campaigned together a few more times, but each outing was more disturbing than the last. He killed and killed. Enemy or ally. Civilian or soldier. Guilty or innocent. It mattered not. If he perceived one to be an obstacle, they died. He maintained that violence was a more efficient solution. It became his mantra. And it broke my heart.
Yeah, another reason why I hate Warcraft.
He hides it well, and intimidates into silence any who discover him. Those who persist have a tendency to find misfortune.
And we should stop him.
I suppose you're right. But I maintain a foolish hope that he might yet be saved and brought back round to reason. I know. It's a silly thing to believe that one so drenched in death might suddenly change.
I'm sorry to have brought this up. It was not my intent to sour you.
Nonsense. We are brothers now. There should be no secrets between us.
All right.
I'll let you know as soon as I have something.
Oh.
So, a question for you. Why medicine?
I'm supposed to tell you I care for my fellow man, right? That I chose this path because it allows me to accomplish a greater good.
Are these things not true?
Perhaps, but that's not what guided me, no. For me, it was a less abstract. I like money.
There are other paths to fortune.
But what better where to peddle than life? Nothing else is as precious nor so desperately craved. And no price is too great for the man or woman who fears an abrupt and permanent end.
Your words are cruel, Benjamin.
But true as well.
You took an oath to help people, did you not?
I abide the oath, which makes no mention of price. I merely require compensation, fair compensation, for my services.
And if they lack the required funds?
Then there are others who will serve them. Does a baker grant free bread to a beggar? Does the tailor offer a dress to the woman who cannot afford to pay? No. Why should I?
You said it yourself. Nothing is more precious than life.
Indeed. All the more reason one should ensure they have the means to preserve it.
All right. I don't know if it's just me, but it seemed like the dialogue wasn't exactly... Like, it seemed like that in each line of text, there's like a 10-second break before someone else speaks. It didn't really feel that natural to me. I don't know if that was an issue with the programming, or it's just, I don't know, it seemed off.
When I know something, you'll know something.
Gentlemen. I believe I found the solution to our problem. Or rather, Odysseus has.
How do you? Are you a new guy?
The Greek hero, you lobcock.
Let me explain.
We enter Silas' fort under the pretext of kinship. Once inside, we spring our trap, free the captives, and kill the slaver.
Dodgy. I like it.
Then, let us begin. First, we need to find ourselves a convoy.
All right, definitely possibly the most challenging mission for me. This early game.
Convoy should be here soon. We'll attack on my signal.
Understood, sir.
If we time this right, we can catch them all unawares.
Ah, Press B to pick up a weapon. Okay, that could have gone better. I completely whiffed my shot somehow.
Charles, you and Williams serve as vanguard. Let no man reach us.
What about me?
You and John will follow from a distance and keep watch over us. I'll signal you when I have need of your services. We're here to help you. Along with those held inside Southgate Fort.
Free me.
Not until we're inside the gate. I can't chance an inspection of the gate going wrong. I'll see you safe. You have my word.
Simpsons of Smithfield, the finest provider of beef.
Do you know anything of Silas' operation? How many men we might expect?
I don't want the database.
The nature of the defense.
Okay, so far...
You must be rather important to him if you were given your own escort.
Sir, we've enemies ahead. Shall I engage them?
No. Let Jonathan and Thomas take care of them.
As you wish.
I wish you'd trust us, though I suppose it's only natural for you to be wary. So be it.
Okay. I'm remembering the later game where you can actually direct your allies to attack. I guess you can't do it here. I'm just wondering if you did.
Engage the enemy!
Oh, you do. You can do that, okay.
God damn it, docks.
Let no man reach us!
I forgot about the guard dogs.
Guard,
of course.
There's something that I always kind of wondered about.
And I'll cut them down.
Engage the enemy.
How is it that the dog could tell that we were not allies when we're wearing British clothes? Like, isn't that how they figured out your scent? I don't know. I just always kind of wondered about that, like...
Hold!
Evening, gentlemen.
State your business.
Delivery for Silas.
Go on, then.
See? I'm freeing you just as I said I would. Now, if you'll allow me to explain. Let her go.
But she'll give us away.
No, she won't.
What's the plan?
Free the captives and avoid detection.
What of Silas?
He dies.
I know when you're ready to strike.
Okay, so take a look at the thing. We need that seriously a typo? Does that seriously say comer spot or does that say corner? I can't tell. Is that actually a typo? No, that's R and it's just the R is very close to the end. Okay. It seriously looks like an M to me. I was gonna say, if this typo made it through to the base game, that's actually a really bad typo. Find a killer general, perform stealth assassinations from a corner spot. General, I believe, is over here. I'm gonna watch this guy move.
Who are you with?
I don't follow.
Lieutenant Wilkins?
No. Man named Cosgrove. Well, Lieutenant Cosgrove.
I've not heard of him.
Cosgrove?
Is he the chap with the gammy leg?
That's the one. That's the very man.
Saw action at Colonial, if memory serves. Put down the clans, he did.
Then try and get.
Bit of an ass, as I recall.
I've never heard of him.
I was kind of worried that they would find, hear me, and I was right to worry. Please don't come this way. I want to get over there to that port in there, but will this guy see me? Waiting for him to come back up and go back down. really don't want to be detected here. I don't know what the heck was with that guy's pathing. Oh, is the general still dead? The general may still be dead.
Lieutenant Wilkins?
No. Man named Cosgrove. Lieutenant Cosgrove.
I've not heard of him. Cosgrove? Is he the chap with the gammy leg?
That's the one. That's the very man.
Saw action at Culloden, memory serves. Put down the clan, he did.
Let's go over here then. The general's still dead, I'll take it. I'm reloading again. It's just, I'm gonna be abusing this in this series, I feel like. Just reload checkpoint every single time I screw up. I'm really bad at stealth in these games. At least in these early games, pre-crouch button. How am I gonna do this? Maybe if I go to the other side. I wanna get the stealth assassinations done first. Go away. Dive. This guy's being annoying. I may just have to kill him in the bush, just so that he just leaves me the hell alone. I'm just gonna kill him in the bush. Because he... away from the kind of curious. If I whistle there, who will actually come? These guys or these guys behind me? These guys don't care that their guy's dead. They're just going back to their spot. Are these cards dumb? Are these cards brain damaged? That should not have happened. Either these guards are programmed with the AI of a... What's the dumbest animal I can think of? Maybe the AI of a cow? I feel like there's probably going to be someone in the comments that was just saying, oh, actually, cows are pretty smart. It's ridiculous. How did that happen? I feel like I should not have gone away with that, but I did. Okay, I just need one more cover spot, and I will get that optional. This is my kill zone, by the way. Everyone comes in here dies. Someone else coming. Oh God. That was an accident. Once this guy goes back to his post, then I will try and whistle him again. Or he'll just go over there. Where is he going? He was over there. These guards' AI is very strange. Alright, well, let's just go ahead and free these guards then. Are these the slaves? I'm trying to get the cover assassinate done. Let me try and whistle these guys over. And they're just walking past slaves that I just freed. So they are not good at their job. Oh, we got the optional objective done. And then saw me. Was it this guy? Over there. Yeah, it's probably him. I want to whistle here, but these guys will come. Hey, big boy. Now, honestly, the easiest part, or the easiest way I found to get on the ship without being detected, just take the water. Sadly, there is a bit of delay if you run out of breath and to resurface. They come and investigate? No, they don't care. Okay, their buddy's dead. I will say though, my heart is beating like 1,000 times a minute. Next one will be... This one will be the challenging one. That guy did not pop up on the radar. Had to not get hit by fire lines once.